In the last class, we discussed the dynamic vibration absorber for a spring mass system. Today, we'll discuss this centrifugal pendulum absorber, which is an absorber for torsional vibration systems. So, here we have a rotating member. Say, you can consider this could be a flywheel which is rotating. I would let you know why I took a flywheel as an example. So, this flywheel is rotating with omega as the angular velocity. So this has a absorber which is called as a centrifugal pendulum absorber. So let's draw the pendulum. So this is say this is a point from which the pendulum is drawn. So this is where the bob of this pendulum is. So this is of mass M, and the length of this pendulum is L. So the force acting along this line would be M omega square. So if this is point A, it is M omega square into OA. So we'll connect this, it is something like M omega square R. So R is this, OA is the R. So this is the radius. So this, don't confuse with this OA and this R. So this is R different. So this is Q. So this is the length of the pendulum. So we have this I theta double dot is equal to minus of the restoring torque. This we have seen when we discussed the simple pendulum. So in a simple pendulum, the pendulum was fixed in one end, but here it is fixed in a rotating member. So that's the difference between this and the simple pendulum. So I theta double dot will be equal to, it will be minus M omega square OA, that is the force acting, multiplied by the perpendicular distance. So let's take this perpendicular distance as H. So M omega square minus M omega square OA into H. Since it is restoring, it is having a negative sign. So we need to find the, if this is, so which is the equilibrium position. So if this is the angle theta, so the pendulum would move from this position to this. So it will oscillate like this. The pendulum will oscillate like this. So it will oscillate from here to here. So this being the equilibrium position of this pendulum. So what happens is, we need to have, if this theta varies, this OA length will vary. So in order to avoid that, we need to have this OA and H in terms of the R and L. So for that, let's consider this triangle OAQ. So area of triangle, AOQ is equal to half into base is OA, height is H, so half OAH. So it is 2 times the area of triangle AOQ is equal to OA into H. This 2 is shifted to this side. So it is 2 times area of triangle AOQ is equal to OA into H. So we need to find what is the area of triangle AOQ. So for that, let's consider this triangle where we know this is R. this is O, this is A, this is Q, this is L, and this is theta. So what will be this? This will be 180 minus theta. So when we know R and L, the two sides and an angle, so area of triangle AOQ will be equal to half into the two sides R into L multiplied by sine 180 minus theta. So this is the formula when you know two sides of the triangle and a angle included. So half RL into sine 180 minus theta. Sine 180 minus theta is sine theta. So it is half RL sine theta. So this is the area of the triangle. So 2 times the area of triangle AOQ is 2 into 1 by 2 into RL. For smaller angles, I take sine theta approximately equal to theta. So RL theta is equal to OA into H. So this is getting cancelled. So OAH is nothing but RL theta. So we'll substitute this in I theta double dot. We get minus M omega square RL theta. So we know that I is equal to ML square for a mass moment of inertia of a point mass at a distance. It is ML square theta double dot, which is equal to minus M omega square RL theta. So we get theta double dot is equal to minus M minus omega square R theta by L. So this is of the form, if you take a spring mass system, you can see that x double dot will be equal to minus k by m into x, that is acceleration is proportional to the displacement. So this is similar to that. So we can write omega n square is equal to k by m for a spring mass system. Similarly, for this we can write omega n square is equal to omega square r divided by l. So omega n will be equal to omega into root of r divided by l. So this is the natural frequency. So what we see here is omega n varies with omega. So this is a very, very important point that needs to be understood here. In the previous videos, whatever we have discussed, omega n would be a constant. So in the dynamic vibration absorber for a spring mass system, when we discussed, the natural frequency of the absorber was a constant. When we fixed the spring stiffness and fixed the mass of the absorber, the natural frequency of the absorber would be fixed. So it would not change. But for this pendulum absorber, what happens is it is a function of the omega. So what it means is, if you want to change omega, still the absorber would work. So how does this work? Because if omega n is changing with omega, so still it would absorb with any value of omega. So that is an advantage over here. So the application of this centrifugal pendulum absorber would be in the flywheels. So this is, say, this is coming from the crank to the flywheel. So nowadays the flywheel is not a single piece of metal anymore. So the recent models of the cars, if you observe, it is called a dual mass flywheel. It is made up of two mass. So this is the first mass, this is called as a primary mass, and you have some springs arrangement over here, and then you have the secondary mass, and then you have the clutch to this attached. And then this goes to the transmission. This goes to the transmission system. So this is from the engine. So what we see here is this whole thing is called as dual mass flywheel, which consists of this centrifugal pendulum absorber which we discussed. What happens is, when the engine is vibrating with say large amplitudes, what happens at the when it comes to this flywheel, the amplitude of the vibration almost reduces. So what happens is the vibrations are not being transferred to the transmission system. So the ride in the car would be much smoother. So if this vibration from the engine is transferred to the transmission system, it would lead to lot of problems. So in order to avoid that, so to reduce the vibrations in the transmission system being transferred from the engine, so we have this dual mass flywheel functioning with a secondary mass over here as a absorber. So this has the centrifugal pendulum absorber. So with whatever speed, so omega can vary over here, since natural frequency of this secondary mass is an function of this omega, so the forced frequency can vary. So it need not be a unique RPM at which the engine is rotating. So even with different speeds, the flywheel would be able to absorb the vibrations. So this is the application. So this is one of the main application of the centrifugal pendulum absorber in the cars. Thank you.